What's up, everybody, and welcome to the first Cloak Reaper Games video in quite some time. Today, we're going to be going for the 100 Par Trophy on Tethy Station. I've got a lot of experience at Walkabout Mini Golf, like a lot. So, I'm going to be doing my best to help you out and show you some pretty cool shots to save you some strokes. Currently, my best record on this course, I think, is a negative 19 on the quest. So, we're going to go into practice first, and I'm going to show you some shots and how we get those done. Then we're going to go into the course and get this under par. If you want to skip the practice shots and just go ahead and watch the run and go at it, skip to the time on screen right now and let's go. Hole one's pretty simple, so we're just going to go ahead and start off with hole two. There are two ways to go about this hole. One is a setup shot for about a medium putt to get a nice two. And there's a second shot, which is a bank, that is very tough to pull off, but you can do it. So here's our simple setup shot for a two. Now there are two dots down there where the ball is gonna stop here. If you stop on the dot on the left, that's the perfect line to get you in the hole. And then we got a somewhat medium length putt, but very makeable, and that'll give you a birdie. So for the second shot, you wanna hit the left side of that wall pretty hard and hope it goes in the hole. It almost never does. Very, very, very rare, and a very thin line. If you miss that line at all, you're not going to be in a good spot. So for hole three, we just got to go all the way around to the hole, and there is another shot to hit really hard that'll take you all the way around to where we are about right now and leave you a pretty long putt. There other one, which I prefer and recommend, is a nice setup and then just a jump straight across off of the reactor right there. About a 3 out of 10, 4 out of 10 on the power, but you can make it. This is another one that's pretty pixel perfect, and you have to hit it hard, so you'll lose a little bit more accuracy. And you gotta hit that reactor just right. You're aiming at the left side of that light with a pretty hard pace, probably a 6 out of 10 or so. And it works, but you're probably not gonna be able to get it very consistently. And if you're going for your under par run, I wouldn't recommend it. I'd just recommend going for the setup. So hole four, this one can be a bit annoying and a little, I don't want to say inconsistent, just tough to get right every single time. So one of your best bets is to try to land right here on the right side of that first hexagon and then onto that second space right there and land by the hole. But it doesn't always work out that way. A lot of the time you'll end up behind the hole or just in another spot like this. But a good general rule is if you're left side of the hole behind something here, you want to put to the right of the hole so that when you come down, you come back down towards the hole. And your other shot is to shoot just right behind the hexagon and try to land in that area with the hole. I don't really have one to recommend over the other one. You just got to go for it and hope for the best. And try to make your putt, man, just hit it really soft whenever you're putting from behind those hexagons or whatever they are. Here we are on hole five. This isn't one of the tougher holes on the course, but it can get you for sure. What you really don't want to do is go off to the side too much because you'll get caught up in these rafters, especially if you hit it too hard, and that's just gonna knock you back and you're gonna be in a bad spot. But what you want to do for this one is that middle light on the wall there, you want to aim just on the right side of it, just like that. And you are going to end up right here most of the time. And the thing is when you hit the walls here, though, they pop you up into the air instead of like a bank shot. That was a little bit too much to the right. So you want to aim almost straight at the wall, actually, but a little to the left, and then try to hope for a good bounce there. Now, if you hit that light really hard, though, you do have a chance to go through that little hole under the pipe and even possibly into the hole for a hole in one. But it's very tough to pull off. And if your line's off just a little bit, you got a pretty good chance of either hitting a wall and bouncing out, or just going into one of the grates on the side of the carpet. But let's go ahead and move on to the next one. So here we have hole 6, and there are a couple ways of going about this one. One is to just shoot it right over the top and go straight towards the hole, which you can get a hole in one doing it that way, but I haven't seen it yet. And the second way is the safer shot, to just go up the ramp as it's turning in front of you and come down the one that's pointing towards the hole. This is the jump shot. If you do the other one though, you usually end up on the right into the corner against the wall, which gives you a longer putt, a little bit tougher because you're against the wall. But if you get your timing right, you can actually get the hole in one going the safe way. Stuff to do though, you got to get the right kick off the end of that that trail coming down, but you can do it. So the first shot, and the one most people do, is just hitting that middle ramp like that and jumping over each wall, but you have a pretty good chance of going off the other side because you have to hit it so hard in the end, but you can do it. For the second shot, safer shot, and usually my preferred shot, is to not hit a ramp actually. Go right beside the middle one and bounce over the walls, and you can hit this one a bit softer so you don't usually go out, but your power has to be just right so you don't hit that first little wall that's right at the end of the drop off. So you can make it, just practice. Now if you come up short and you get in a spot like this, if you're on the left, you want to cut close to that left wall so that you go around without clipping the ball on the right, and I'm gonna show you what it looks like after this next replay. Apparently, if you hit it too far to the right, yeah, like that, you clip that wall on the right where that light is, and you just don't get the bounce you're looking for. Alright, hole 8. This is one of the toughest holes on the course. If you can come out of here with a 2, that's friggin' awesome. A 3 is great, and par is just fine. It is really easy to stroke out on this one. But our objective here is to land on that rock and land into the one next to the one with the flag. That's the safer, best bet. And you want to go just to the right of the middle of that light right there. Land right there and land into that one. You do have a chance to land in the one with the flag if you get it just right, or you're actually going for that, which is just basically hitting the ball harder. Now, if you're lucky enough to end up somewhat straight with the hole, you can hit it over, and you want to try to go over the hole, hit the ball, and come back into it for a 2. Now, if you want to go the whole way, which is very difficult to do every time, you're aiming at the same spot, but you're hitting it a lot harder by trying to hit higher up on the rocks. It's not super consistent, and it's probably going to take you 3 or 4 tries to make it. But you can do it, but if you're going for your under par, I'd highly recommend just going for the 2 or 3 that I showed the first time. Alright, hole 9, very easy, very simple. Just a medium pace, 5 out of 10 hit, right there, and down for the hole in 1. Alright, hole 10. It's a simple hole, but a tough one to pull off the hole in 1 on. The power is super deceiving. Most of the time you're going to come up just like a foot short of the cup, and you got to hit it just a little bit harder than that, but it's kind of hard to tell. You got to hit it a little bit harder than you think you do. Probably, I don't know, a 6 out of 10, maybe a little bit lower. There is a dot here to aim for, but of course it's going to be hard to see on this clip. But the hole is straight in front of your ball in a direct line, so if you just follow your ball in a direct line, you should be able to find this dot or smudge, and just, you want to shave the left side of your ball on that smudge, and it'll put you in the cup every time. Hole 11, we got a few shots here. One is a more risky, but it'll save you a stroke, and that's the one we're about to do here. And the second shot, which is a much safer one, is to go off of that left wall there where that light is and just bank yourself over in front of the hole or possibly in the hole. It's just very, very tough to get the power right and the angle right off of that wall to go into the hole. But it'll shoot you out of that tube and down there for a medium length putt or so, and there's the safe shot. So this is the third madman shot. Don't do this if you're trying to get your under par run, but you want to land on that rock on the right side, on the flat face of it, facing the hole, and try to get lucky like that. But good freaking luck, man. I don't think I've ever seen a hole in one on this hole until I accidentally did it in practice here. It was cool though. Sweet dunk. So hole 12. It doesn't look like it, but this is actually one of the tougher holes on this course. So from the tee, whenever you hit the hill, it's going to break to the right because you're left of the cup. And there is a little smudge next to a dot. So I'm pointing at the dot now. Of course, it's hard to see on the clip. And just to the right of that dot is a little smudge. And you want to go anywhere over, left, right of that smudge, just really close to it. It doesn't matter because it's 100% all about your power. The kind of break you're going to get. I'd say it's probably about a 3.5 out of 10 on the power level. Good luck on this one. Hole 13. If you play it the right way, this is one of the easier holes. You got to go down through the loop de loop and down to the end with the hole. So the first shot is the safe, easy shot I go for. So that little point on the carpet, you want to go just to the right of that point. Soft shot, probably about a 3 out of 10. And just fall off that edge nice and easy to roll down for a short putt to the cup. Second shot is to smack the crap out of it like that, but your line has to be pretty on point. You want to go just next to the point, right on the left of it, and hope for the best. You got to hit it really, really hard, like super hard, so you're going to lose accuracy. So hole 14 is all about your weight. Really, I just try to go in the middle off the carpet. There's a dot there. It's not a bad idea to kind of keep close to that dot. But it's 100% just a weight shot where you go around this wave. Try not to go up too high and hit something like that or come up too short. But you'll be able to get it after a few tries. And then you just got to put it in. But I'd say this one's probably about a 4 out of 10. Hole 15. This can be one of the toughest holes on the course, and it can't make your game, but it can certainly break your game. So we gotta go past these two holes with these meteor type things in it. And so we're gonna try to ride the right edge of the first one, but power's gotta be on point. And so there are three stripes on the outer edge. A dark one from the furthest right, a little bit lighter one, and then another darker one going inside the hole. You want to run over that light stripe, the second one going towards the hole, or the top of the third one, and you should be safe there as long as your power is on point. A hole in one is possible here. You want to get a little bit more curb and try to go over the side here, something like that, and get a curb off the wall, but it's a tough one to do. Good luck with this one. You probably should practice it before you go for the power run. A lot of people have trouble with the timing on this one, but what I like to do is go through this first frame as it comes around, and if you're looking through the middle of that frame, when you see the next one inside of that frame is when you want to hit your ball. So this one coming around the left right there, as soon as you can see the wall from that other one through that hole, that's when you want to hit your ball, and you want to hit it with a pace of probably about 5 out of 10 because you want to have the speed to go through that next hole and not hit the wall. And this does have hole-in-one potential. Hole 17. There are a couple ways of going about this one. The first one is the way that I usually do, but it is risky. You want to ride the right edge of that hill and come down the very left edge of it, and that'll possibly give you a line to the hole. Not often do you get this line. It is tough to get it just right, but it should get you close. And that was my puppy jumping off the couch. And it's just a tough one to get, but you, if you want to play it safe, you want to just hit the left edge of the hill. Like that. And that won't get you the line, but it'll get you in a position to put your ball over there to get the line and put it over for a three. But there is another shot. So this next shot, I don't really recommend, but I'm not knocking it. I haven't really practiced it, but we're going to start off with just doing a setup on the right side, pretty close to the hill. Surprisingly, this only took me like 5 tries to get, but you want to aim super, super right of the cup, almost straight at the hill from where you set up at. And you have to land on that gray piece before the carpet so that it steals all your momentum and you don't fly off the edge or roll off of the edge. And you can dunk this straight in the hole, and that's what most people go for. But yeah, definitely a risky shot, but hey, if that's your thing, go for it. Hole 18. So there are a few ways to go about this one. I recommend just playing it the way that they want you to play it, actually, the safe way, which is just to hit it over to this left side nice and easy. And then we're going to hit it against the wall to go to the other side where the flag is and knock it into the cup. It's going to be different where you need to hit this wall each time. It all depends on where you end up off of the first shot, but it's going to be a nice pace, probably about a 5 out of 10, and you want to bounce off of that wall without going up the top ramp and coming back around again. And a little pro tip, this wall that it has me standing on right now, if you're having trouble getting behind your ball to take your shot, you can fly through that wall from behind it to be able to see and take your shot, which I should be about to do. Yeah, there you go. Then you can put it in from there. Alright, let's go do our under par run. And so, keep in mind when I say the power of shots, they are going to be a little bit different from yours, obviously, because of different putter strengths. I like to keep mine at 85%, and that's where I find my sweet spot to be. First hole, simple. Just hit it past that barrier so you have a line to the hole. Get it in two for a birdie. And here we're going to go for the setup for the two. Come up just a little bit short though. So I'm just going to play it safe here. Take it through the little line there and take the par. That's okay. We'll have plenty of room to come out under par by the end of this. And so here on hole 3, I'm just going to do the normal setup here and shoot off of the reactor. That's probably about maybe a 2 at the most on that setup, and then about a 3, 3.5 to jump it over. For this one, there's a couple different ways. I'm going to go towards the middle, I think I went for, and you're going to get lucky sometimes. Sometimes you're not going to get lucky, and that's kind of just how the putt crumbles on this one. Had a little bit of luck there, ended up in a nice spot to make my next shot. Par here is just fine, we'll take that. So here on this one, we're going to smack the right side of that light right there. Wasn't a very good shot at all, but it turned out to be. I got really, really lucky on that. Gonna see a replay here and see that I actually went off of the carpet, had enough speed to hit the wall and not fall in the grate, and got a really lucky bounce. I didn't quite get the hole or the line to put into the hole. There's a little bit of the pipe in the way. So I tried to knock it off of the brown bit on the left side here, but I couldn't see my ball or the wall or anything, so I kind of missed it, but that's okay. I think we're still going to pull the birdie here, so. couple different ways going about this one. I prefer the safe shot. Almost got the hole in one. It's possible. It's tough to do though. This hole can bite you. But we're gonna try to get it down there in one. Right off the middle ramp. And we made it. That's a tough one to do. That one's probably, if you're going up the ramp, probably about a 4 out of 10, somewhere around there. This is one of the worst holes in the game. Don't worry if you stroke out. As long as you don't do too bad on the rest of the holes on the course, you should still be able to come out under par. Luckily, we made it over on the first shot, and I like to just go in this one and get closer to the flag. Jumping straight for the other one is not nearly as consistent, and I like to hit the back of the wall behind the cup with a little bit of speed so I roll back into the cup whenever I get my setup there. Nice and simple here, probably about a 5 out of 10 or so. That's the gimme hole on this course. This is a very deceiving hole on the power here, and I can't believe I hit this short. I was, I guess, just a little too focused on the line, or really I just got complacent at this point. I was having a pretty good game. The wheels start falling off here pretty soon though, I think, but we make it out with a pretty respectable score anyway for this course. And I come up just the tiniest bit short again. That's how it goes sometimes. Moving on. I was actually trying to play this one safe, I think, and come up a little bit short. But, man, I really almost made the bank, and I don't think I've ever done that before. It's tough to do. If you watch the practice stuff before this, I actually hit one of the trick shots here and dunked it into the hole. It's pretty cool, but I don't count any practice shots at hole-in-ones myself. This hole used to give me trouble a lot. We're just gonna send it up to the cup on the left side, aiming at the left side of the cup, because when we hit the hill it's gonna break right like that. We almost made it, super close. That one's probably about a 3.5 out of 10? 3 out of 10, somewhere around there. It's a, you don't have to hit a lot of the shots on this course very hard. Nice and easy, right next to the point on the carpet. But I actually went on to the point on the carpet there, was the issue there. You want to go just right of it. That's a lot better. This is one you can hit really hard if you want to go for the hole-in-one, and you got to hit it really hard, like probably a 7 or 8 out of 10. This one was an issue for me for a little while back in the day, but we're going to have issues again. I think this is when those wheels started coming off. There we go. Nice and lucky, hit the wall there so we're not against it, and got an easy putt to the hole. This one will mess your game up, man. This hole will mess your game up. Luckily, we make it in one. Almost in the hole in one, but we made it across in one, and that's what really matters for this one. I think I nearly got a hole in one here and just barely missed it. It was close. Well, I thought it was closer. It must have been a different game. Yeah, I risked it for the biscuit on this one. Kind of messed it up a little bit. Yeah, not enough power. We hit that too soft. I got lucky. I almost went off the edge, and I thought that was what was going to happen. Because if you go for that shot and you hit it too soft, you got too much angle coming back. And yeah, here's where the wheels really came off. This is, if you get your power up into the 90s and stuff like that, it makes these touch shots really, really tough. And that's why I try to stick around 85. But sometimes those touch shots are still just a little too touchy. Now I'm going to miss the putt, too. This was a rough hole for me. I think we were a negative 17 at one point. Or 16 or 17. We were 16 right there. This one's pretty simple. If you're going to play it the safe way, which I recommend doing, is what I pretty much always do. The trick shots here are pretty tough, and they're not safe if you don't get them just right. Yeah, this was awesome. Love that. Now we get to wait for it to drain. Well, let's give it another shot. Keep going out. My goodness. I don't remember this happening. This is bad. Holy crap. Wow. That was... Whew. That's a rough ending to an otherwise pretty good round. These last two holes tore me up. But anyway, that's Tethy Station. Hopefully I was able to help you get under par. I honestly didn't want to give away all my tricks. But here they are. I'd rather help you guys out than keep it all to myself. I don't need to be selfish like that. But I pulled a negative 14. Man, that could have been a negative 19 game, no problem. If I just played the last two holes how I should have. But you know, that's how it happens sometimes. We all have our days on here. But anyway, hope this helps you out. Glad to be back. Please don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. Let me know which courses you want to see next and done the quickest, and I'll see you in the next one.